previously in Phanero.
In Luke chapter 1, God appears to a couple, a priest named Zacharias and his wife Elizabeth. The angel of the Lord appears to her and tells her, "You're going to have a child. He shall be great in the sight of the Lord. He shall neither drink wine nor strong drink, and he shall be filled with the Holy Ghost from his mother's womb." And the Bible tells us in verses 17, "He shall go before him in the spirit and power of Elias to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children, and the disobedient," he says, "to the wisdom of the just," and he says, "to make ready a people prepared for the Lord." Allow me today to teach something concerning the wisdom of the just. We all know that the word for wisdom is Sophia. And wisdom, Sophia, is the mother of two wisdoms. One is sunesis, the other is phronesis. What is sunesis? Sunesis is the critical faculty in the understanding of a man that helps them reconcile truth, that helps them interpret divine oracles, not at the speed the normal human being is able to understand, but at the speed the Spirit of God is able to give you. And then we have phronesis. Phronesis is the wisdom that allows your mind to define the action, the application in whatever circumstance you're going through. Phronesis is practical wisdom. Sunesis is interpreting. Phronesis is the practical version of wisdom. To think and interpret a thing right does not mean that you know how to execute it. Joseph, at the dream of Pharaoh, by sunesis, knew what Pharaoh dreamt and its meaning. But it's one thing for him to know the meaning, and it's another for him to have the wisdom to help Pharaoh interpret by investing for a harvest in the times of plenty and storing up food enough for the time when the famine comes. Now, back to Luke 1:17. "He shall come before him in the spirit and power of Elias to turn the hearts of the fathers to the children and the disobedient to the phronesis of the just." To the practical wisdom of the just. A man is blind and Jesus walks to him. He could simply lay hands, but he chose to spit on the ground and make something out of his spittle. The Bible tells us he puts it on the man's eyes, the man's soul. He could have done it anyway. But phronesis is the true and full experience of the liberties that we have in God to manifest his glory. It liberates your spirit to know that I don't need to do it the way I saw another man do it. I can choose to do it any way I feel. By this liberty, when you learn this, you will move many things with your spirit. Now let's go back to what I was trying to tell us here. Let's first understand this thing called wisdom of the just. When you became born again, you were justified by God through faith. So it means when you became born again, you are not righteous because of what you did, what you have done, and what you're going to do tomorrow. You are righteous because you believed on the Lord Jesus Christ, who became the perfect sacrifice for your sins. And when he was sacrificed, God declared you righteous. Somebody say, "I am the righteousness of God in Christ Jesus." So the Bible says, Jesus has been made our wisdom, our righteousness, our sanctification and redemption. 1 Corinthians 1:30. So you're redeemed, you're sanctified, you're righteous, you're wise. It's important to know this because Satan has ways of putting guilt on you. When Jesus came, he took away our guilt. He left us with a conviction because we need to live right, but he took away guilt because he did not come to condemn us. You have been justified through faith. And that righteousness came with a certain wisdom. The Bible says in Proverbs 2 verses 7, "He layeth up sound wisdom for the righteous." The moment you became the righteousness of God, he sounded wisdom in your spirit. It didn't come as a voice, it came as a sound. So anybody who doesn't appreciate, embrace, understand the righteousness of God through faith does not carry a certain wisdom with God, especially phronesis. People who don't understand righteousness by faith don't know what to do when they're in trouble. The moment you say, I am the righteousness of God, you embrace a certain wisdom. Hebrews 5:13. For everyone who continues to feed on milk is obviously what? Inexperienced and unskilled in the doctrine of righteousness, of conformity to the divine will in purpose, thought, action. And the Bible says, for he is a mere infant, not able to talk yet. What does that mean? Even though physically you have good words, spiritually you have no power. There is only a place for vocabulary if you can open a blind eye and a deaf ear. But if a deaf ear can't hear you, keep your semantics. God is looking for somebody who will walk to a blind man and tell them, see, and the eye will open. Why? Because they are able to talk. When you understand righteousness imputed through faith, you get a language, you get a certain authority. Your prayers come with a weight. Every word you speak is heavy. It envelops someone. It clothes them like a cloak. It stirs them because you speak in understanding. You minister in understanding. Whether you're a pastor, whether you're a business person, whether you're working in the government, wherever you are, your words will be weighty. Why? Because that wisdom comes with great power and authority. Now, wisdom, the just, they know practically what to do. It gives you a certain mindset. You set your mind right because you're just. The Bible says the path of the just. See the wisdom of God. He says the ways of the righteous or the right living glow with light. So if you embrace righteousness, your way will glow with light. And the Bible says the longer you will live, the brighter you will shine. The wisdom of the just, it sets your mind to know that tomorrow morning is better already. You might not have rent, you might not have a car, you might not have fees, you might not yet be married, you might have not yet seen your miracle, but the wisdom of the just will cause you to embrace tomorrow morning. Tomorrow morning is going to be bright. Next year is going to be bright. 2024 is going to be bright. 2025 is going to be brighter. 2026 is going to be brighter. This is the wisdom of the just. Now, I don't care whether you have a generational curse of your grandmother's auntie. I don't care who bewitched you last Tuesday. This is the truth. Yes, things might come and shake you a bit, but you are the righteousness of God. This is to make ready a people prepared for the Lord. What are they prepared? For God to do his best in them, through them. The Bible says that the Son of Righteousness shall rise with healing in his wings. That means because you are the righteousness of God through faith, you cannot be sick. Laugh at the devil! So you see why you must be healthy? Because you are the righteousness of God. Hebrews 10:38, if you study the literal translation, that portion of scripture that does not say, now the just shall live by faith. It actually translates as, those justified by faith shall live. That means everything they do will be alive. It's the working of faith in this instance is secondary to firstly receiving righteousness through faith. Then the life begins. But the Bible says, for if any man draw back, my soul shall not have pleasure in them. Verses 39, because you're the righteousness of God, we are not of them who draw back to perdition, but we are of them that believe to the saving of the soul. We stick on it until the answer comes. Why? Because in every circumstance, we know we are right. I know I'm right to say that I was healed by his stripes. I know I'm right to say that it became poor that I might become rich. I know I'm right to claim my victory. Thanks be to God, which always causes us always. Why? Because we are his righteousness. There's going to be an always causes us to triumph. Why? Because you are the righteousness of God. So if you say, I am healed, God says, you're right by Christ. Wisdom of the just. Everything you speak, the angels hasten to perform because you're the righteousness of God. You're right. There's a portion of scripture that says he fills the mouth of the righteous with wisdom. Because you're the righteousness of God, you learn to speak with wisdom. I can't be broke. I'm a success. I'm progressing. I'm increasing in strength every other day. Glory to God. The glory of God is upon me. His countenance shines on me. Ay, 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 ay. Wisdom of the just. If you want to understand what I just said, understand this. When you become the righteousness of God, everything you speak, you're right.
Join our online family, spread the love, and follow us on Facebook, Twitter, Instagram, and also subscribe to our YouTube channel. Finero.